As you know, not one person can truly marry you. You marry yourselves. By mutual commitment to love each other, to work toward creating an atmosphere of care, consideration, and respect. By a willingness to face life's anxieties and trials together, you can make your way to life more steady and real. On this day, you stand somewhat apart from other people. You stand in the light of your love, and this is as it should be. You will experience a lot together, some very wonderful, some challenging. But even when it is difficult, you must manage to overcome the strength and the love you two have for each other to get you through. From this day forward, as you come closer together than ever before, you must love one another with the strength, sincerity, and passion that makes this bond beautiful. As you exchange your vows, remember that the sensual aspect of love is so beautiful when it is combined with real friendship, trust, and respect, that all is infinitely enhanced. All of us here today, speaking to you two special people, we wish for you a love that continues to give you joy, peace that provides you with energy to face continued responsibilities in life. We pray for a home of serenity, and we pray that as you grow older, you are able to look back at your lives and say these two things to each other. Because you loved me, you have given me faith in myself. And because I have seen the good in you, I have conceived from you faith in me. Now, a reflection from a family member, Christine Marula.
Marriage understands and forgets the mistakes life is unable to avoid. It encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, and new ways of expressing a love that is deeper than life. When two people pledge their love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique unto themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. Marriage is a promise, a potential made in the hearts of two people who love each other and takes a lifetime to fulfill.
In sickness and health, joy and sorrow, we pledge to him your respect and your love. Andrew, we promise Caitlin that from this day onward you will stand with her in sickness and health, joy and sorrow, and you pledge to her your respect and your love. The couple has written their own vows in love and honor of each other.
Together we've gone through the ups, downs, sideways, and everything was conditional. Everything that we've done and gone through has allowed us to make it to this day because I love to teach others in front of our family and friends. And today, there's some promises that I want to make to you that are right in my head. I promise to love you every second of every day, to be there for you when you need me, to be there when you don't want me. I promise to support you any decision you have to make and go with each other. I promise to be there for you no matter what I feel about it. I promise to give you that full revenue for your dashboard and take you to the venues as often as possible. I promise to go over to you and continue our journey together to this work. Okay, and you make me a better person and improve by being you every second of every day. You're the most amazing person I've ever met, and I truly love to have you here with me. You're my daughter, my best friend, and my baby.
These rings are an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Caitlin and Andrew in the bond of matrimony. In the presence of God and these friends, seal your promises with rings, the symbol of the life you will share together. I bless these rings and all that is holy and all that is sacred and all that is divine. Be a constant symbol of God's presence and your promise and grace throughout your marriage. Andrew, repeat after me. In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of the vow made between us. This ring, I be wed. Caitlin, repeat after me. In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
The vow made between us.
The vow made between us.
With this ring. Promise of commitment. this moment onward, totally united. And with the passage of time, may their home truly be a place of love and harmony, where your spirit is ever present. We thank you, God, for their loving families and the friends who accompany them today on this journey. And we pray them to always be as supportive. Bless this union and walk with Caitlin and Andrew. We ask these things in the glory of all that is divine, by the grace of God our Creator. Amen. Andrew and Caitlin, on behalf of all those beloved present and the endearing spirits of those beyond, in the strength and commitment of your love for what God has joined, let no one put asunder. In accordance with the laws of the state of Connecticut, I pronounce you husband and wife. And we now kiss the bride.
Thank you. Welcome to Caitlin and Andrew's wedding reception. We would like to invite everyone to please come on out to the dance floor. Everybody up out of your seats. Everyone up out of your seats and make them surround the dance floor on this side and this side. We're going to leave an opening right here. Please show Caitlin and Andrew how much you love them. Please join in and say, "We love you," on the count of three. Ready? One, two. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to Caitlin and Andrew's wedding reception. My name is Jim and I'm serving as your master of ceremonies today. On behalf of Caitlin and Andrew, we would like to welcome all their family and friends that are here. Now, before we introduce our wedding party, I'd like to take a moment to introduce some very important people in Andrew and Caitlin's lives. Their parents, everybody. There we go. First, I'm honored to introduce Caitlin's father and mother, married 38 years, Chris and Regina Rowe. It is also my privilege to introduce Andrew's parents, married 30 years, Mike and Denise Murillo. Coming in right now is our ring bearer and flower girl, Liam Burke and Ava Murillo. Look how cute they are. Come on down. And festive. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to bring in our wedding party. Are you guys ready for them to come in right now? I'm sorry, I didn't say that loud enough. Are you ready for them to come in right now? That's what I wanted to hear. Coming in first, here's Pat Piscato and Aaron Amrando. Of honor, Lindsay Berg and best men, John and Chris Murillo. gentlemen, friends and family, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Put your hands together for two amazing people, and the reason we are all here, please welcome the new Mr. and Mrs. Andrew
First, I would like to thank this young lady to the left here, Chris Allen, because she wasn't supposed to be here tonight, and we remembered her from Lindsay's wedding. I remember her over 5 years ago, and she did such a fantastic job. And when I was coming to book this, she said, I can't be there. And I'm like, what do you mean you can't be here? She said, well, I have a prior family engagement. And I'm like, okay. So, well, anyway, she worked around it, and she's here.
Thank you.
And she's still there. Stella's going to make her family engagement up on Cape Cod, which is where I think I believe I was, and I wish I was there. Well, no, not right now. Now, at what's going on here today, my wife, Regina, or Gina, depending on how you know her, I know her both ways, but she's the same person, I promise. She was a McNeil, I am a Rourke, and definitely an Irish reunion. And we were kind of maybe thinking that maybe all the kids would do that too. There's going to be Lefty here, I promise. So my daughter Lindsay was in a wedding party. She married Weston Burke, very Irish, and it wasn't even that much of a name change. It was Burke. I said, this works out really well. So that was easy. My son Tim, he kind of went off the path a little bit. He found a gem, believe me. No emerald green in it. I've done some searching. There's no emerald green there that I could find. So I have to figure out in my mind, well, how do I make this work? And I'm like, well, wait a minute. Her name's Rourke now. So, you know, it's Rourke. So she's Irish as far as I'm concerned. So then here comes Caitlin with this Murillo kid. I figured he'd go away. He didn't go away. And why would he go away when he has such a prize sitting next to him right now? Plus, I fed him way too well when he came to the house. He has a voracious appetite. Meeting the family, it's a wonderful family. The one thing Caitlin told me ahead of time was, now when you meet his father, he's going to say happy birthday. whatever, I can go along with anything. So it was great, and I've met everybody. They're wonderful people, as most of the crowd is here tonight. And I'm very happy about that. So now I still have to make this an Irish thing. So I found out his mother's Irish. Courtney. Right? So I'm like, oh, okay, wait a minute, this could work out. And they've been married 30 years. So looking at this whole thing, and I know there's probably a lot more Irish couples or Irish Italian couples here. I'm saying Irish Italian instead of Italian Irish because I'm talking. So Irish goes first. Irish goes first. So I got that all worked out in my head, so it all works out. And I do have to mention one more couple. My sister is here, and her husband, Susan, I call her Sue, Theodore, that I call Ted, Vozella. That's V as in Victor, because Ted would always say that on the telephone when he was explaining his name to somebody. V-O-Z-Z-E-L-L-A.
That's Irish.
Irish.
And in October, they will be married 52 years. So, on the day they got engaged, there was a very dark cloud that came over 29 Hassock Road that engulfed the whole house because my mother said, this isn't going to happen. And it's never going to work. Well, obviously it's worked. So that's the end of whatever I have to say. I want to thank everybody for being here because without you, it was pretty damn boring. So have a good evening. And to this lovely couple that seemed to have everything going their way, and it seems like it's going to go a long time, raise your glasses and toast the wedding couple.
Good evening, and thank you all for being here tonight to celebrate Caitlin and Andrew. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Lindsay, and I'm Caitlin's big sister by 5 years. Now, 5 years doesn't seem like a real big age gap, but when you were little, let me tell you, 5 years was a huge, annoying gap as a big sister. When Caitlin was a baby, everything was great, and it was awesome to have a little sister. But as she got older, having a little sister became more and more annoying. Who would have known we would end up being the best of friends? Caitlin wanted to be just like her big sister, which now I know is quite flattering, but when I was younger, not so much. I started dancing when I was 3 years old, and for 5 glorious years, all the attention when it came to dance was on me. Costumes, pictures, recitals, all me. Then, when I was 8 and Caitlin was 3, she started dancing too. Okay, no big deal, I can handle sharing the spotlight with my little sister. But then it came time for our dance pictures, and my mom told me that we would be getting our pictures taken, wait for it, together. Well, my entire world came crashing down on me, which now, looking back on it, is quite silly. But at 8 years old, I was not a happy camper. And on top of it, that year in particular, Caitlin had the most adorable ballet costume, and I had this weird yellow, black, and hot pink cowgirl costume. So of course, she was just the most adorable ballerina on the planet. This tradition of us having our dance pictures taken together continued until my senior year of high school, and every year I dreaded it. Now looking back on those pictures, they make me smile, and I'm grateful I had a little sister to take those pictures with. Now, I could stand up here and tell lots of stories about tormenting Caitlin throughout our childhood. Tim and I had fun giving her a hard time, pretty much all the time. Caitlin was the most beautiful baby, and that didn't change as she got older. The attention was always on her and her big, beautiful green eyes, long eyelashes, and perfect ringlets in her hair. So naturally, Tim and I felt that we should blame her for everything, and at times make her do all the things that we didn't want to do. When there was melted gum on the deck, it was Caitlin. When there were dishes left in the sink and not put in the dishwasher, it was Caitlin. And when we were playing in the pool and the basketballs got tossed over the side, we made Caitlin go get them. She would run to my parents and tell them how awful we were being to her, and we would get spoken to, but it really never stopped us. Caitlin was a trooper, though, and I'd like to think that taking all that abuse from us over the years helped toughen her up for later in life. At least that makes me feel a little bit better. So many of you may be wondering when Caitlin went from being a pest of a little sister to becoming my best friend. When I went away to college, it was my first time being away from home, and it put things in a whole new perspective. It made me realize how lucky I was to have such an amazing family that loved and supported me through good times and bad. When Caitlin was a freshman in high school, she was asked to move up from the JV cheerleading squad to varsity, quite the honor, as normally freshmen are not allowed on varsity. I remember walking back to my dorm from class when I got the call from my mom that my sister had been dropped from a stunt at practice and broke her elbow pretty badly. She was in the hospital waiting to find out if she would have surgery. My heart dropped, and all I thought about was how quickly I could get home to be with her. That next week in the hospital with her was mostly a blur, but it was definitely the turning point in our relationship. We spent a lot of time together that week and had both good moments and bad, but something changed during that week. She was no longer my annoying little sister that always wanted to do everything I did and never left me alone. She was more mature and easier to talk to. She was in pain and scared, and I wanted nothing more than to take it all away from her and put it on myself instead. From that week on, she was my person, and not only my little sister, but my best friend. And of course, we still had our sibling moments, and we'll continue to have those moments for many years to come. But she will always be a blessing to me, and the first person I go to when I need advice or a shoulder to cry on. She's caring, thoughtful, and one of the most selfless people I know. She's a compassionate nurse and an amazing auntie to my son and daughter, but that may be because she always has jelly beans in her purse for Liam. She will be a supportive and loving wife to my new brother-in-law, Andrew, and I am honored to be her big sister. Now, Andrew. I have to say, when Caitlin first told me about you, I became very protective because that is what a big sister does. But one of my very first questions to Caitlin was, what is this football team? You see, Caitlin and I and our entire family are Jets fans. And when chatting with a guy, one of the first questions we would ask him is, what is your football team? If he answered the Patriots, we literally just walked away. Because there was no way that Caitlin or I could date, God forbid marry, a Patriots fan. Right, Dad?
Yeah.
Yeah? So when Caitlin told me that Andrew was a Cowboys fan, I thought, okay, I can work with that. Andrew, you have been so good to my sister from the start. You make her happier than I've ever seen her before. You put up with our loud and crazy family and with the fact that we are indeed Jets fans, and can deal with my sister always wanting to cuddle and that she is slowly but surely becoming a cat lady. You are the perfect balance to her, and with you in her life, I know she will always be taken up and be treated like a queen. I feel like you have always been a part of our family, and I know I speak on behalf of us all when I say how happy we are that you are now an official member. She has never smiled like she does since she has met you, and for that, I am forever grateful. So, Caitlin and Andrew, I've only been married for 5 short years, so I'm no expert, but as you start this beautiful, crazy journey we call marriage, I will leave you with a few small pieces of advice. Always remember to treat each other with love and respect. Never go to bed angry. Keep surprising each other. Do the little things just because. Compromise. Andrew, never turn down Caitlin's request for a foot rub. And Caitlin, if you know it's good for you, never let Andrew go hungry. I love you both so very much and are so very happy that you'll be spending the rest of your lives together.
Great advice, but for myself, as an unmarried and untethered single man, my marriage advice is sort of limited. My wisdom is limited. However, the one phrase that I like the best, and I got it from my sister-in-law, Christine, and I believe it rings true, and well, it makes for a great Hallmark card, it's a pretty phenomenal hashtag. It's happy wife, happy life. So, in the world I've seen, Christine, you make Andrew as happy as I've ever seen him, and I hope that he makes you as happy as it looks like that you are tonight. Okay. Last but not least, I'd like to do it like a college essay and finish by quoting somebody. So I'll quote the Beatles and I'll say one final thing. All you need is love. Love. Love is all you need. And they have found it. God bless. Everyone have a good time tonight.
When you say family friends, have a nice round of applause for four very well-placed hosts tonight.